I call for an international emergency conference to reorganize the bankrupt financial system. The tremors in the financial system felt around the world, triggered by the run on the Silicon Valley Bank, its subsequent closure and being put under compulsory administration, are the clarion call for the governments of the world to act quickly to prevent a repeat of the 2008 crisis on a larger scale, larger and more deadly, because all the so-called tools of the central banks have been exhausted. Given the extreme over-indebtedness of the financial system, coupled with the derivative exposure of $2 quadrillion, the everything bubble is threatening to have the fate of what Wall Street guru Bill Gross compared to a supernova, a bright shining star that suddenly burns out. Between this killer of financial tightening, triggering growing margin calls and a run on the banks, as it occurred before the trouble of the SVB, and the charybdis of reverting to QE, letting hyperinflation eat up the debt, there is no solution within the system. In either case, be it a sudden collapse of the entire system or a hyperinflationary devaluation of people's lives' work, the potential damage to billions of people and the likely death of millions is unacceptable. The failure to address the root causes of the systemic crisis of the financial system in 2008 and the 15 years since of reckless creation of liquidity by QE, zero and even negative interest rates at the disadvantage of the physical capacities of the economy, in combination with geopolitically motivated economic madness, such as sanctions hitting the Western economies in a gigantic blowback, is resulting in a blowout of the system. Neither Schachtian austerity, nor bailouts, nor bail-ins will remedy the situation. Only an end to the casino economy and a return to sound investments in the real physical economy aimed at increasing the productivity of the economy through capital-intensive and energy-flux-dense economic production will do. If Franklin D. Roosevelt would be alive, he would declare a bank holiday, implement a Glass-Steagall banking separation, a new deal, and offer American participation in a new Bretton Woods system according to his original intention to supply massive credit to increase the living standard of the people of the global South. Unfortunately, it can't be expected that the current US Congress has the stature or wisdom to do likewise. While the efforts of the Eurasian Economic Union, the Shanghai Cooperation Organization, and the BRICS Plus to create a new commodity-based currency and a new financial system may not have progressed sufficiently, given all the kinds of restrictions and remnants of the previous approaches, the drama of events could force the realization of existing intentions to be sped up. Since the very real possibility of an uncontrolled collapse of the financial system could accentuate the danger of the present proxy war between NATO and Russia, with China in the background, to escalate by accident or miscalculation, urgent action is required. There must be an immediate emergency conference whereby governments signal to the world that they will act together in goodwill to move to a new global security and development architecture, taking into account the interest of every nation on the planet. The first expression of such a new architecture could be the implementation of the four laws proposed by Lyndon LaRouche: a global Glass-Steagall system, a system of national banks, a new credit system, and international cooperation in the next generation of scientific and technological investments, such as thermonuclear fusion and space science. This emergency conference must take place either at the conference of the UN General Assembly or the G20. If these institutions are unable to respond, then other sponsors must be found, such as the BRICS Plus, the SCO, or a combination of representative institutions. When the well-being and possibly existence of the human species is at stake, all ideological obstacles must be overcome.